What's up, what's up, what's up, collective? Howdy, howdy, howdy. Welcome! Welcome, welcome to Gemini Lion Gate. Sorry. Jenna. Welcome to Gemini Gate Port 888. Welcome. I'm so happy to have you here. I wear stocking caps and sweaters and because it gets really cold in this room. You know, I smoke, you know, and I sage. And so I have the window open. So just to let you guys know, like, I'm freezing all the time. I don't know if you can even hear me with the introduction song. Okay? Welcome. This is a channel where I channel messages from your guys to my guys. And when I say I channel messages, I mean I channel messages from your spirit guys to my spirit guys. Okay? Thank you for all you guys for been viewing my channel, your comments, your likes, and people that have been subscribing to my channel. If you're new here, or if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please press that subscribe button. It does help my channel grow, and it'd be very much appreciated. It's free. It doesn't cost a thing. Okay? No, I don't need to describe, you know, to touch on your energy. I could, if you're watching me, I could collect your energy, okay? That being said, these are general messages, okay? Keep that in mind. Not every message, not every video is going to be your reading, okay? That also being said, remember, energy can be present, past, and future. Being the collective, my collective, I do trust you and I trust your intuition, okay? Flip it where you need to. Remember, this could either be about you or someone directly or indirectly involved with you. What else? Let's see here. Yeah, so just this is how I do it when I listen to tarot card readings on YouTube. I take what feels familiar, sounds familiar, situation and events are familiar to me. Because we all have a familiar story, not a similar story. Okay? I pray for Archangel Michael to send back any negative energy, any black magic, any word curses, any witchy chanting, whatever, towards my energy, towards the collective's energy, towards my platform, towards our family. I ask you, Archangel Michael, if you can send back to sender times 10, and I'm ready for you, spirit. Come on through. I do smoke cigarettes and I smoke my tobacco, my vape, and I cuss a lot. You know, if you get offended, this might not be the channel for you, but you know, that's just who I am. And I drink coffee and and tea, and I sip on some Italian cream sodas. Now I made my kids Italian cream sodas tonight. It's actually really good. All you do is get club soda and half and half and, like whatever flavor you want. I just got some lime because they didn't have any flavor at the store. I live in a really small town. So, you know, like the lime that you put in margarita mix, but then I made some like cherry Kool-Aid and I just sweeten it up really good. So it tastes like a cherry lemonade, and I put a little bit of touch of 7-Up in it. So it's really, really, really tasteful. Let's roll the dice. Okay. Ooh. Oh, I don't have the little baby dice in here. Hope everyone has having a good week, good day, whatever time it is. I've been having crazy dreams. I don't know about you guys. I always have crazy dreams though. I have a hard time remembering my dreams, though, if, like, the day goes out. So I'm trying to remember what my dream was last night. Oh yeah. I was like in a beach or I don't know. But it was cool. I was in this house, like a tree house, like a giant tree house. Not like a beach. I didn't see an ocean, but it was like a jungle type area. And I was sitting there and I was drinking coffee. That's all I can remember. I don't know what else the dream was. I don't know who else was in there. I just remember it was really pretty. It was at peace. This is why I usually have a hard time. I don't know about you guys, but if I don't write my dreams, like the minute I wake up, it's like I forget about them. Except like the really, you know, important ones. And like scary dreams, like, you know, I don't really take them as like I don't know, I don't really have nightmares, but dreams that make me feel uncomfortable, I don't take them as something bad. Like, you know, I take it as a sign. So three, you're communicating, you're talking. Good communications here. You get information and communicate. Gemini energy, I could be talking to a Gemini. Your health, maybe you're talking about your health. Give me one more. 22, okay, so I got 22, that might be significant. You might be born on the 22nd. Also, the second house is, I believe, let me see. I'm learning astrology. I do have my phone here because, like I said, I don't like bullshitting you guys. I know 3 is a Gemini. 6 is, let's see here. What's going on with me tonight? Someone's not well. This could be healing. This could be, but let's see. Hold on. It's like the quality of life, the things we have responsibilities to do, whether you're showing it up at work. I heard the sixth house could be about, it's the house, yeah, it's your health. It's the house of health, you know, implant, maintain good health, ability to cope, face adversity, which someone is talking how you can. Hold on. Because you got the second house out here. Someone in bad health is talking about your, and this second house, about your material wealth. Because the second house talks about, like, assets. But it also talks about, like, your finances, material possessions, concept of values, but it also could talk about like someone else thinking about your finances. This is the house of possessions. Signifies the way someone attracts or repels money, also the way that he or she chooses to spend it. This is a Pisces. I didn't know that. Wait, hold on. No, that's not Pisces. Second house zodiac. Is it a Pisces? It's a Taurus. Yeah, Taurus, Gemini. So I could be talking to a Taurus, a Gemini. Who's in the bad health. Sixth house is... a Vertigo. So a Vertigo might be in bad health? It involves that one's work, well-being, individual cleanliness, daily schedules, and duties. Because they weren't, Fourth house talks about, I made my dad a pineapple cake today. Oh, pineapple cake. Ancestors, roots, you're protected, your Akashi records, ancestors, caregiving figures, yeah, but it's a Cancer. What's the seventh house ruled by? Is that a... That's relationships, but is it ruled by a Libra? Being gravitated up to a partnership. I feel like you're not in bad health, though. There's a lot of... There's communication, talking about your material wealth because someone's in bad health, because you're protected by your ancestors. This could be someone that you were in a relationship with or are in a relationship with. 6, 7, 8, 9. The ninth house talks about... That's Aquarius energy. That talks about, like, spirituality. What's the sixth house doing out here, Spirit? What's the sixth house doing out here? One of these days, I'm just gonna go, that's gonna suck. I'll film it too. Six again. Someone is not in good health right now. Mm-mm. And I really feel like this isn't you, collective. Let's see. Let's ask the pendulum. I really cleanse my pendulum here. Pendulum. Pen and pendulum. Spin around. I like to wrap my finger on this one. Pendulum, pendulum. Spin around. Pendulum, pendulum. Is there any tricksters, evil spirits that could affect you right now? Give me a yes or a no. Is there any tricks or spirits that can affect this reading in my messages? Thank you. Okay, pendulum, please stop. Okay, pendulum. Is this the collective's energy, this sixth house? No, it's not. Is this the collective's energy? Mm-mm. Is there someone in bad health talking about the collective's money? Is it what this is about? Kindness or I need to be more direct. Is this someone in bad health talking about, yeah, see, someone in bad health is talking about how you're making money, if you're receiving money, something of that sort. Thank you for that, pendulum. I don't know why. This can be a vertigo. Doesn't have to be. Someone that wears a really cool hat. Puppies. Someone that has puppies. Someone that's pregnant. Someone has, like, babies. Someone that puppies. Someone that has spectacular abs. Someone has, like, really good abs. Well, they're... So they must be in good physical health then. Chemical weapons. Someone was using chemical weapons. Some type of chemicals to hurt somebody. Lunchables. Lunchables. Really cool hat. Someone can have the letter L in their name, 39. Wondering if it's possible to get some of that salsa to go. Look at all these cards. I always feel like I get the same ones. Ooh. A salty surprise for someone. Selling crack to children, 44. What? I've never seen that one. What? Okay. Where's my... Okay. Someone could be 39, 44. These are masculine energies. Someone is hustle. Someone sells drugs to children. The American Dream. This is like their American Dream, but something. This might be actually on the news that they're gonna get in trouble. Poverty. These people, you know, are poor. So they sell crack to children. They someone's selling drugs to children or did. That's fucked up. Even when I was on drugs, I never fucking. Maybe someone said that you did that. Because I remember sometimes when somebody accused me of that, I was like, what the fuck? I was like walking by the house. I was like, what? You gotta be fucking kidding me. The Great Depression. How amazing it is to be on mushrooms. Someone could like to take mushrooms. Okay. I feel like there's definitely an addict out here and a drug dealer. Okay. That energy is coming through. Someone, a female, could be born on the 18th. Some goddamn peace and quiet. Someone wants this person to shut up, or maybe they want you to shut up. Yeah, this person wants you to shut up. Letter S. It's a feminine energy because it's in the pink. All right. And then I got the letter D, the Kool-Aid man. 30D. Masculine energy, 39, 40, and 30. Letters L, initials L-O-S-D. SD card, someone could have an SD card that's significant. On the low, because they're L-O, maybe they're doing something on the low. You're busting out like the Kool-Aid man. Okay, a really cool hat. Someone likes to wear really cool hats or something. This person is expecting a child, perhaps. Someone might be born on the 7th. Really cool hat. Someone could be a life path number 7. If someone's a life path number 7, if they're not walking by faith, you know, or by God, they can be an addict. So, and someone has the initials D. What the hell? Someone has the initial D's. Puppies. Maybe they just have puppies. Okay, the letter W. Spectacular abs. Life path number 9. Or 6. Chemical warfare. Again, 7. 79, 97 could be significant. E. Wondering if it's possible to get that salsa to go. Someone's name could be Lee. Something about P.E. A salty surprise. P.E. 8. Someone could be born in 87, 89. Someone could have the initials G that likes to hustle. Something about G. Someone thinks they're a G. G-E-L-C. C wanted the American Dream. Again, C again. Something's going to be on the... Someone with the letter C is going to be on the Fox News. F is in poverty. Letter O. Is this... Yeah, O. The Great Depression. T. How amazing it is to be on mushrooms. The letter B. And D keeps coming out. D, D. Yeah, SD card. B. Some... SB, BS, someone thinks something's BS, so shut the hell up. DD, DS could be significant, like, you know, Department of Social Service, DSS. DDD, someone, okay, let's see here. Well, this is an L, sorry, my bad. So definitely someone with a LE. So I see 89, 87. 78, 79 could be significant. 98, 97. Someone could definitely be 39 or 30. Because if you're born in 80, what, 9 or 87, you're 39. Someone could be born on the 9th. Someone could be born on the 8th. Someone could be born on the 7th. Someone could be born in August, September, July. The 18th, even maybe the 30th, September 30th, August 30th, July 30th, OTV, BD, someone that has an SD card, or something about an SD card, to leap. DW, EP, someone might have the initials CT, CBT, something about weed maybe, do, OD, OCD, someone might have OCD, got, someone got something, and got the SD card, someone got an SD card? You know the SD cards in your phones? CF, FC, GC, CG, TC, CT, LD, DL, on the download. I feel like someone has an SD card and someone's gonna find out something that they were doing on the download. Some for some of you guys. So someone wearing a really cool hat, puppies. This person could be having puppies or something about puppies. Someone has spectacular hats, abs. Well, someone's in bad health, but they were doing something with chemical weapons, like with chemicals, selling drugs, selling crack to children because they're poor. This person's going to have a salty surprise. They're going to be on the Fox News. They want you to shut the hell up because you're busting out here like the Kool-Aid man. Someone likes to take mushrooms as well. They feel like they're in a trip right now, like something surreal because they're going through a great depression. Someone was hustling crack to children because they thought that would be the American dream. Someone could be real short or tiny, like petite. Someone wants to know if it's possible to get that salsa to go. Yeah, someone is selling drugs. This person could have puppies, or they just have puppies. There's like a drug dealer that is dealing with puppies right now, or children. A drug dealer that wears a lot of cool hats, but this person sells drugs to kids. And you could be out, this person is very depressed right now. Very depressed. They're gonna have a salty surprise and they're gonna end up on the news. Well, yeah, if they're selling drugs to kids. OTBD could be significant. GCCF, LEP, DW. Someone can have an SD card from an LG phone. Flock. Someone's follows the flock. Whale. Wall. Call. Cap. Cap. Or cape. Dabs. I don't know, there's a drug dealer out here that does chemical weapons. It's like they hurt. I feel like also someone was trying to hurt someone with drugs. Like, you know how sometimes people put fentanyl? I don't know if people do heroin anymore. When I mean, you know, that was like a long time. Well, thank goodness, thank God. You know, I haven't been in that scene in a long time, but, you know, when I was, like, doing drugs, it's like, we used to test our drugs, well, I did my heroin to see if there was fentanyl in it, and now, I never got on the fentanyl thing, like, I, you know, thank you, I've been sober of opiates since 2019, and I remember everyone hearing about these fentanyl pills, and I thought it was so strange, because me and another guy were going, we were like, oh, yeah, we got these. You know, we got me and this other addict, we were, you know, recovering addicts, and I was in this program called Drug Court. And we were like, we should go to, you know, hand out Narcan and, you know, fentanyl testing strips. And they're like, people do fentanyl now. And I'm like, what? And it's like, Someone could have done something. I don't know why I'm getting this. To hurt somebody. Children? There's only one female out here with the letter S or feminine energy. I feel like that's the person that's petite. Does puppies resonate with you? Now, I don't know. I feel like it's not someone pregnant, but just think about something about puppies. And whatever, think of a time, a situation where it's like puppies were involved, or you met someone that had a lot of puppies. Something about puppies. That's that person. I hope that makes sense. Something about puppies is like, it's going to resonate different for each one of you guys. Okay, for example. So, let's see. So say if you had an ex-partner that, you know, used to breed dogs, that like that might resonate for one collective. But then the next collective is like, you know, say that, you know, of the next door neighbor is a drug dealer and has a bunch of puppies. Does that make sense? Like literally puppies is like something about puppies, like little dogs. Like that's what I'm getting with that. So think about puppies. Okay, and that's going to resonate with you. I hope I'm making sense with that. I hope that makes sense, what I'm trying to say. I don't know why that's coming in strong, puppies for me. Like, say... like, you know who your local drug dealer is. You know what I'm talking about, being in a small town and they have puppies in their yard. That person might be connected to this reading. I don't know. Give me more spirit. What's this sixth house doing out here again? Who's in bad health? A bag of magic beans. I told you, this is like a drug dealer. I don't know why I'm thinking about a drug dealer right now. That the Bachelorette season finales, that thinks that you're the bee's knees in town or in your community or where you're at. The Underground Railroad. 46S again. Someone goes from a feminine energy to a masculine energy. This person could be born on the 18th. Be 46. The letter S initials. Poor people. Again. People that are in poverty. Like, I'm not thinking about poor-minded people. These are people that, you know, don't have money. Old people that smell. Someone has a weird odor to them. It's like, they're like, well, obviously, if they're poor, I don't know. Maybe these are, like, homeless people, and they can't... anyways. You know, they can't take showers. I always found a way, though. Just saying. There's this one chick. I was homeless on the street. She was so gross, collective. Getting really high. I can't make this up. These are druggies. And, oh, it was so gross. And my ex, he slept with this chick, too. She was so gross. Like, would not take a shower. Would not. And I'm like, had places. I even took her. I'm like, because I would find places. I would hustle for a shower more than I would hustle for drugs. And there was even go to a gas station, you know, a truck station or something, man. And this chick would not take a shower. It's like that type of energy. is like just homeless people. And they feel like these people are in bad health. And they feel like you're the Bachelorette season finale, or they wanted to like make sure that you would never be with anyone else. Selling you a bag of beans, maybe? Underground Railroad, doing something, tunnels, building tunnels, these people who live in basements or something. And there's a person that really smells because they get really high. That's crazy. My daughters. I think she's laughing so hard with that movie, Madagascar. I love it. She laughs like me, like a guy. What's this bad health? Who's in bad health here? Oh, now you want to shut the door. Sister. Yeah. Oh. Remember, honey, you can't stay up too late. I'm a single mom. I try to mention that in my videos. Like, you know, I take care of my mother. She's a diabetic, and I take care of her, and, you know, I have elderly parents, and I have two kids, and I do, and a dog. So I do have to periodically sometimes walk away, you know? And I know people are like, why don't you do your videos while your, you know, kids are sleeping, this and that. I'm like, because I'm sleeping when they're sleeping. Type of thing, you know? You know, single moms out there. My collective, you know what I'm talking about. All my single moms out there. You get it. What's this bag of beans? Eight of Cups in reverse. Someone didn't know how to walk away from a bag of magic beans. Someone thought they were going to get the jackpot or something. Someone wanted to... It's like this feeling of not wanting to work hard. Well, obviously, you're selling crack to children. You know, hustling. These are not... I'm not trying... Hey, collective, you get it. We've been there. You know what I mean? Like I said, I'm a recovering addict. I'm not saying every addict is a bad person, you know? I'm not saying that at all. Like, but there's something about these particular people that do drugs that are, they're not good. It's, their energy's not good. It's not. It's real muddy. Well, when you're getting high, your aura is going to be like an orange, brownish color. And that's what this is. It's really muddy. It's like, there's like a people, poor people. And I'm not trying to say this in a bad way. Because like I said, I was homeless once. But you guess I still held, I had one thing in life, and that was my motherfucking integrity. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, I was down and out, but I still held on to one thing. I always did the right thing, even if I was in the wrong motherfucking place, you know? I still try to be a nice person, a good person. Understand that we're all down and out. But I'm not getting this in this energy. These people were trying, all they care, it's like, let's see, let's keep going. Someone, Eight of Cups in reverse. Someone didn't walk away from something or regret walking away. Because it's like, the Eight of Cups on the Alright talks about, you know, you're walking away from the cups, but and you're willing to go through those mountains happily. But Eight of Cups in reverse is like, it's like relentless, like moving away from something, but you are still confused and, whether you should leave or you should stay, because right now, yeah, it may be finding difficult to leave behind some of the financial security in pursuit of something better for you. A distance person who keeps you waiting. Oh, that makes sense. Yeah, so this it's like this with the strength in reverse on the bottom of the deck. Someone was just like I feel like someone's stuck in the past. Someone doesn't know how to... I feel like this is like an energy is like they have no choice. A bag of magic beans. It's like, what are these magic beans though? Is this drugs? Is this money? Is this like an opportunity? What are these magic beans? Battlefield amputation 26Z. Someone might have the initial Z in their name. Zachary, Zach. Zane. This is a feminine energy. I don't know, letter Z for a female. Having sex for the first time, what, with a battlefield amputation and magic beans. This is gonna be a long reading. I'm not accepting reversals on these ones too, Spirit. Yeah, your distance. Yeah, you and your partner may be physically and emotionally distanced. Someone was wanting to keep you waiting because this person really thought by selling drugs or selling bags of weed or whatever, crack to children, was going to be a great idea. And this person really took something from you. Battlefield amputation. Letter Z might be significant. The number 26 might be significant. Having sex for the first time. Ew. Anyways, this is a shitty partner. That I really feel like also use drugs to get women to have sex with them for the first time. It's like, it's not a good energy. This person was keeping you waiting while they were doing fuckery shit behind the scenes. Just say that. If you're dating a drug dealer, okay, collective? If you dated a drug dealer, you know what I'm talking about. It's fucked up. Two of Pentacles. This person's off balance. This person is dropping the ball. Because here you are, the Bachelorette season finale. Like, they know you're the bee's knees of the town. Okay? This person is sick, I feel like. Or they can't heal from something. And it's crazy. Look at how these two pentacles are. There's no pentacles in this. There's two people. But this is in reverse. This person looks imbalanced. However much weed $20 can buy. This is a drug dealer. This is someone that is in the drug scene. Like, getting really high. I come on through, Spirit. Like, I'm telling you right now. This is an addict. This is someone that, yeah, this has to do with addictions. That life, collective. And someone can't balance that lifestyle out no more. A raptor attacks because they could be being attacked by a bunch of people. Rhythm of Africa. They're out of rhythm. Because maybe they were coming after you like raptors attacked. That always reminds me of the movie Jurassic Park where the guy's on the motorcycle and they're, you know, the raptors are coming out after the dinosaur. It's like these people are coming at you viciously. A group of addicts. If you're a recovering addict, you know this is your reading. Okay, nothing to be ashamed, we're all been there, okay? And you had a group of addicts coming at you hard, however much we can buy, because you were the Bachelorette season finale. Also, I'm getting with that is like, these people didn't want you to be with anyone else. It's like, they wanted to make sure you would not be a Bachelorette. Or maybe you were going to get married to someone. No, I really feel like also, like, they know you're, like, the person, if I'm talking to a feminine energy, you had, okay, say if you were dating a drug dealer, okay, and they were out having sex with all these, you know, dope whores. I don't know. And these dope whores knew that you're the catch of the town. But obviously you were some fucking asshole that kept you waiting because they were getting some type of clout. Attention. It's that energy of like, you lose, you snooze, buddy. This person is so off balance. Two pentacles in reverse. Yeah, this person is not doing very well. Health issues could arise. I cannot make this up. Because someone was really trying to figure themselves out, their sexuality. This is like an energy I'm telling you right now that will be with male or female, males or females. If it's a, I don't know. There's someone out there like clout chases. They like the attention from anyone. And now this person is in bad health. Because they're in that party scene. Now someone's building tunnels or they were building, someone could have been like underneath your house or your place doing something. 46S. Cause they got inner demons. My inner demons. Hell yeah. Shit, I found my inner demons. That's why I got so, yeah, this is someone very sick in the head. The Wi-Fi password. Did I not say they had something to do with an SD card with an LG phone? Letter S. Z, Z, S, S, Z, Z, S. Maybe that's a code for something. White people. 49 Z. Something about, I told you this person, look at this person goes from making a pouty face. This person's all fucking butt hurt about something with life. Cause they are going there. Look at ZZ. This person goes from masculine to feminine. This is a bisexual individual. Okay? And considering they were just like, it's cool to be bisexual, but they're fucking they could have got, anyways, their health. They were not taking care of themselves, okay, in this party scene, and just say that. And this person is getting sick or going to get sick in the future. If they don't know it now, they better take care of themselves now because they better go get tested. I don't know. It's that type of energy. It's like this person was doing the most behind the scenes, you know, being a drug dealer, selling maybe to underage girls, you know. Girls that, you know, getting little, 17, 16-year-olds fucked up on drugs so that they can have sex, take their virginity. Ooh. I don't want to tap into this. This is sick. I guess I have to say it. So, like, you know, it's like a drug dealer that sells to underage girls. So, you know, he could take advantage of them. Take their virginity away. This person's fucking sick. Ugh. This is sick. What? This was your soulmate? Oh my god. Ugh. Collective. I've been there. Listen, you're okay. You're okay. This person isn't okay, but you're okay. If you're still around this person, that's someone that sells drugs, you need to get the fuck away from this person. Because I feel like this person's also going to get in trouble with, like, underage girls on their phones. Because, I mean, the Fox News came out here. Maybe this, like, if this person goes through a raid or the cops roll them up, they might have underage girls on their phone because they were getting them high to take away. Ugh, this is so fucked up. This person is at least someone that gave you their cup. I'm so sorry. A collective, I get it. But it's like this. Ooh, I just gotta get past through this energy. I'm here to help. I'm here to get these messages out. Okay, let's see here. Let go. Make room for the new beginning. Yep. Make room for the new beginning on its way to you now. You let go of this person. You're letting go of this person. And now you're going to get a real soulmate. You got to remember, we have more than one soulmate on this planet. On this earth. In this dimension. In this D3D world. Okay? And if God knows your soulmate is doing this fuckery shit, nasty shit behind the scenes, God will put a little person in a nice little gift basket and be like, here you go, collective. Because this individual is sick. This person is sick. Selling to underage girls. So he, I don't want to get past that. I don't like that. I don't like that at all. I don't like that energy. Ooh. This guy is a creep. A fucking creep. If you don't know, you don't know, collective. This person should be ashamed of themselves. For reals. And they want you to shut the hell up. You know, they want you to... Maybe you're calling this person out. I don't know. And it's like, this person was also like... messing around with men and women. You're safe though. With the fourth house out here, you're protected. Because you let go of this person. Mm. That's how you could get a new soulmate. I don't know. I don't want to tap into this energy. I mean, I'll get the message out because you need to hear it. But let's just get through this. And then let's like get through this. Just go past that because... someone might get in trouble for fuck around with underage girls. Just say that. Or they, it's like they're being exposed for that. Because they're poor. These are just people that are just... like I said, I was poor. I was homeless. I still made the fucking right choice. God damn. There's a fucking line. Men. Poor people, men. Men? Poor people, men? Ethnic cleansing. These people have... some type of prejudice. White people. These people think that they're like little Nazi people. Like skinheads. Lifetime of sadness. Only dating Asian women. Ooh. Okay. 43. Cute. I really don't want to tap into this crap. I also get this energy of... it's like weird, dude. This is dark. This is like serious. This is like a human trafficking weirdness type deal. Ooh, child. Move on. Someone is not available. Let go. Begin, because this person is not available. Will never be available because this is a sick individual. They'll always cheat on you because they're always wanting attention from men, women, underage girls, especially girls that are younger, vulnerable, that are, ooh, that pisses me off. Pisses me the fuck off. You know, men out there that sell drugs to younger girls because that's so fun. Like, I just gotta get through this reading. The Chariot. This person will not be victorious. This person cannot move forward. This person, it could be, there could be a Cancer. Move on. Move on from this person, collective. This person is like, fucking bad. Bad. Over, like, I can't. It's creepy. It's a very serious, I can't even, it's like tapping into a horror movie. It's weird. I really never tapped into an energy like that. No, I have. Like, yeah. I did an ex. He was a drug dealer. A reminder to take responsibility for your inner resistance and make choices. This is a red light. The Chariot me is a red light. Do not move on. Okay, if you're hanging on to this person, don't. Because they're not hanging on to you, okay? They're really not. This person is stuck. It's essential is nurture and physical, emotional well-being. This person is not nurturing themselves. They're not fixing themselves. They're not moving forward. They're not, they're like, it's like they don't set goals in life. They're, they can't triumph over anything because they have a really sick mind. This person could be sick. Old people smell. This person is, has something with their odor. They're dry heaving. They're throwing up a lot. Kissing grandma on the forehead and turning off her life support. 20. Someone could have the initials U in their name. Maybe their name is like Eunice? Unique? Z, that's so weird. Z, Z, these are really, someone has a really unique name. Like, it would be very, it's very different. There's a feminine energy out here that could be connected to this masculine. And maybe this feminine energy knows this masculine does this shit. Why are they coming out in your reading, though? Well, this person is someone that you shared a cup of love with. This is your soulmate. If you don't know it, then give it time. In divine timing, things will flow. This individual is really sick. They're really sick. I really feel like they caught something bad. Because you're protected. You could have used protection with this person, and you dodged a bullet, to say that. Seven of Wands, you're defending yourself. You're protected. You are protected here. So just give it some time and things will flow. Because, yeah, cleanse your energy from this person. Because this is just a weird, I mean, it's not weird. It's dark. It's really dark and scary, actually. So someone's getting really high. Lockjaw, woman in a yogurt commercial. There's a female out there that does not take care of their fucking hygiene. I'm telling you right now, there's a female out there that is gross. Again, I was homeless. Like, there's ways. There's ways. I was never, This person is like, someone wants someone to shut the hell up. They can't start 40. There could be a cancer significant. I don't know. It's like, someone could have tetanus. What is it? Like lockjaw? Someone is in really bad health right now. They're going to be. Finger painting? Someone was trying to paint a picture of you because they wanted you to shut up. So these people need to shut the hell up, actually. What are these? Someone was keeping you waiting because they wanted to juggle you. This person is so off balance. This is a soulmate connection that cannot move forward with you. So you need to move on. Let go. Make room for the new. Because, yeah, Page of Pentacles. Because you're learning something new. These people are learning life lessons here. Page of Pentacles talks about a life lesson. And this looks like it's going to be a hard lesson for these individuals or individual. Yeah. You're breaking. Yeah, you broke up with this person. Divorce. You're done. You're over it. Experiencing a breakup. Someone is. There's like a really weird individual. Okay. Well, I asked, right? So someone was keeping you waiting because they wanted to juggle you, but they can't anymore. This is a soulmate connection. Someone that gave you at least their a relationship with. This person cannot move forward with you. It's a red light, but you're protected, and this is a life lesson that you learned. Thank you for that, spirit. This is a life lesson that you learned. This individual is not going to change. This individual is going to be 60, 70 years old, selling drugs to younger girls still, and doing the same shit. I'm telling you right now, it's just, like, fucked up, but it is what it is. And you're, anyways. Let's see here. Yeah, this person reaping karma. because they wanted to bully you, and they can't anymore. Maybe, let's see here. I already pre-shuffled these. Okay, what's going on here? Two of Cups again! To the Hierophant in reverse? This is someone that should have gave you their Two of Cups. But you left this person. You broke up with this person. With the Hierophant in reverse, this is like a breakup. Like, you don't want to be with this individual. Is this Hierophant, like, marriage? Okay, is this a marriage or a dark spiritual? Okay. Pendulum. Is this a dark spiritual leader? Is this, like, talking about a breakup, the Hierophant in reverse, like a divorce? Okay, is this Two of Cups in the past? Is this a... Let's see if the Ace of Cups come out. Is this going to be a new soulmate connection for the collective? This is someone hanging on to your energy. This is a past person that you were with. Now, listen. If your past person didn't sell drugs... They were part of the party scene, okay? They were around drug dealers that were doing this type of shit. This is your message, okay? You're like, since last week, you're just like done with this person. You don't want to be with this person. You're breaking up with this person. The contract is broke. You broke this contract with the Hierophant in reverse. You broke the contract with this soulmate connection has been broke. Come on through. Knight of Wands, because this person didn't want to save you. Anti-hero energy. This person is like doesn't want to help you. Didn't want to be there for you right now as you speak. This person is an anti-hero energy. Anti-hero is like, let's get a little bit deeper with that. Hold on. Anti-hero, let me see. Let me really... Anti-hero is like... Lack a conventional hero. This person is not a heroic, you know? They don't have heroic attributes. These are baddies and goodies become less distinguishable from one another. This is like the evil villain. You know, the anti-hero is like a character in the story may lack some conventional, non-conventional ways because this person is very taboo, okay? Very taboo qualities, attributes, such as idealism and courage. Anti-hero typically exhibits one of the dark trait personality traits. Because I saw anti-hero in definition for psychology. Narcissism. A sociopath. A Machiavellianism. Told you, it's that type of energy. This person is dark. Lacks conventional heroic attributes like optimism, honesty, strength, morality, virtue. Instead, they achieve their goals through cynicism, deceit, frailty, insecurity, and vice. This is that type of individual. This is like a narcissist, a sociopath, a psychopath. It says psychopath. The difference between a psychopath and... Okay, a sociopath is someone that will hurt you. How can I say? I don't want to say feel more remorse about it. A psychopath, it's like a sociopath is like more, I don't know, like a ritual or like they have like a moat, like an MO. A psychopath is someone that just lacks the like empathy. This is a very empathetic energy. This is someone that will do it to whoever, whenever, anytime. Does that make sense? As a sociopath, usually is like someone that has like a particular person or, I hope that's making sense. I don't want to get into psychology, but just say that. This person is don't care. They don't care, collective. This is a soulmate that does, if this person does it to the bitches that he was cheating on you with, these dope whores, this person treats everybody in their life like this, okay? And feels no remorse for it. This is a very, this is a very scary individual that you need to stay away from, because obviously you need to move on, because they're not available. They're really not available. They're like, check the fuck out. And I told you, this person is reaping a lot right now. This was a soulmate contract with a villain that with a contract that is incomplete, okay? But this person is stuck in a cycle and will be of karma, destiny, fate. They can't go nowhere. But you overcame it. You're going to overcome this, collective. Thank you. Thank you. It's kind of getting scared there for you. I'm not trying to freak you out, but it's like, this is a very dangerous individual. This is a person that's like, this is not a good person. Not a good person, collective. Again, if you're ex, because you're not with this person. There's a breakup. This person is... Oh, why did I do that? I mixed them up again. This person, either I'm talking to a Sagittarius, or this is a Sagittarius, or there's a Sagittarius involved. But these two of cups. I'm either talking to a low vibrational... Okay, there was definitely a low vibrational Cancer that was involved with this. Or it was your ex-partner, or there is a low vibrational Cancer that's going through your breakup. Like, okay, a sociopath is a type of person that will, like, look the part, as a psychopath would be, like, a homeless person off the street. Like, they don't care what they look like. That also, too, if that makes any sense. A water sign, either talking to a water sign, or... there was a water sign that was involved or indirectly. Place it where you need to place it, okay? Saturn, something about this person, this order right here. Order in the court. That's what I just heard. Order in the court. This person is getting in trouble. A low vibrational Libra that she overcame. Something was very unfair. With the Cancer being reversed, Cancers are very... if they stay in their shell way too much, they can be very emotionally abusive towards others, okay? Not only to themselves, they could be emotionally abusive towards the others. A Sagittarius, it's on the upright, but... what the Sagittarius is, because maybe you're supposed to have a soulmate connection with the Sagittarius, because you had a Cancer that was in the middle of it, and this water sign is, I don't know. So I'm feeling the other person, that other one fading away. Thank you, Spirit. I'm like, ooh, it's creepy. That one was creepy. Ooh, okay, thank you. That guy is creepy. It's a guy. It's masculine energy that's bisexual. Anyways. What's this Two of Cups out here? What's this Two of Cups? What's this? Give me some outside influences. What's influencing this Two of Cups? The Fool. A Pisces energy? Someone is not optimistic and they don't feel good about... because they're not having a new beginning. They know that this someone also didn't want to go on this journey with you as well, collective. Okay? They didn't want to have this. It's like God gifted them this Two of Cups, and this person didn't refused it. Okay? So this is why this contract is being broken in the ethers. Okay? To the Fool, to the Ace of Wands in reverse. This is like no new beginnings. But this individual doesn't understand. Whoever this psychopath is, he doesn't get it. He can't have these Two of Cups with anyone else now. Because the way he went about it was in a very fucked up way. It was very deceitful. It was very seedious. So this is why he's reaping karma in the future. While you're resilient, you're overcoming all this. This person, if they thought they were going to have a new beginning, they're not. Like, the moment they left you, they were like, okay, cool. And now they could be breaking up with a Cancer, or Cancer could be involved, and they're breaking up with that person. Thinking that there's no new beginnings here. The Fool to the Ace of Wands, that talks about there's no beginnings here. No new beginnings. Like, not a new start, not a new opportunity. This world in reverse is heavy. This is heavy karma. These are bad, like, that's it. This is God saying also, no. Thumbs down, no. Move on from this person. You see how the thumb is? God's like, You got rid of this person, or someone got rid of somebody with the Hierophant in reverse, a non-traditional marriage, relationship. Because this person is fucking crazy. Everyone also sees that this person is crazy. There is an outside influence. Like, you could have had a soulmate connection with a Sagittarius, okay, for instance. And you had maybe your ex-partner or whoever could have been a Cancer. Somehow, stop it. Like, this is also like a foolish energy. Like, whoever the Sagittarius didn't see you, like, it was very foolish of them. Now, this is also the way I'm reading this as well, is like, this Two of Cups should have been, it's like, but they didn't want to have a new beginning with you. They didn't want to start a journey. So this is why this person is not having a new beginning, because they don't want to go on this journey with you. So they don't get to have a new beginning. And they're very confused why. They're very delusional about why. And the thing is, this is outside influences. So everyone else is seeing this. It's like publicly these people see that these people aren't going anywhere. That these people lack something. That they're not innovative. They're not, nothing's coming through for them. It's chaos. With the world in the seven, it's chaos in their world. Can't self-actualize. They can't. They're losing all their options. There's no more options for these people. Or a soulmate. Wow. Like, that's so crazy. This one hurt. Had to if it was a soulmate. Ace of Cups. I told you. This person was supposed to offer you a cup of love. And the reason why they didn't have this relationship with you, I don't know if you know this individual. Like, I don't know. This would be crazier if you didn't even know this individual. Okay, does the collective know this soulmate? Does the collective even know this soulmate? Because we sometimes have soulmates we don't know. What? That's crazy. Does the collective know this soulmate? Shut the fuck up. I knew it. Does the collective know this soulmate? Like, been in this relationship? No. What? You had someone that had the opportunity to be in a relationship with you. This is crazy, collective. Okay, you don't even know this individual. Like, you could have met this individual in passing. This person could have had the idea to be with you. This Sagittarius or low vibrational Cancer, and considering they didn't give you this Ace of Cups, they're very confused because they're like, why do I have to go through this karma? But they were not following their divine guidance. What? That's so crazy. Or you had people, a water sign that was blocking them. Poor Libra. This was your twin flame. To the Two of Cups, to the Four of Wands. What the hell? That was stingy. Hanging on to your energy. Hanging on to money. Penny pinching. There is an outside influence that cannot let go of a happy environment, that can't let go of a home. Four of Wands and Two of Cups talks about twin flames. I usually don't read stuff like that, twin flames, because I hate twin flames. I don't hate them. My twin flame was a fucking nightmare. Cause a lot of a Libra, cause a lot of injustice for you to have a happy home with an individual. Because they were stingy. They were hanging on to someone. Someone was hanging on to something. And you overcame this, or you will overcome this to a happy home, celebration, a marriage, an outside influence. My son, he's still up. Neptune. Very complex. I feel like this Sagittarius is very confused. Why? They were supposed to maybe Scorpio, low vibrational Scorpio, Vertigo energy. That's not going to have a spiritual expansion in a new relationship. And you also have a low vibrational Scorpio and a low vibrational Cancer that are not going to have new beginnings. They, I don't know, because they were doing something bad with technology. Told you, with a phone. With communication. What's this Two of Cups? Why does this Two of Cups keep coming out? Lovers. What? I don't understand. Like, Gemini energy again? Gemini and Sagittarius are brother and sister energies? This is someone that is like, I don't get this. This is... Okay. Are there two soulmates out here? Hold on. Are there two soulmates out here? Is this two soulmates? Is this like a karmic soulmate and a lover soulmate? Okay, so you were with a karmic. Okay, thank you for that, Spirit. Okay, you were with a karmic soulmate, a fake twin, okay? That was, whoa, that's gonna smack me in the face. Look at that. I'm on the right track. Okay, you were with someone that was involved with the party scene, that was on drugs, could have sold drugs, that was having sex with underage girls, is a fucking psychopath, okay? A narcissist, okay? But now you have this Sagittarius coming in, okay? This is your real twin flame. You've never met this person, okay? Does he know the collective, or does she know the collective, the Sagittarius? Does they know each other? Has he ever seen her or seen him? Does he want to be with the collective? Or do they want to be with the collective, the Sagittarius? Does the Sagittarius want to be with the collective? No. Does the Sagittarius want to be with the collective? It's like they're confused about you. So is this Ace of Cups in reverse, that karmic energy? Okay, is this soulmate going through a breakup? Is this soulmate going through a breakup right now? Or going to be going through a breakup with a water sign or some shit? Is this why is divine timing? Okay. So, okay. Lovers, this is with the Four of Wands. Okay, you have, okay, whatever that was in the pre-shuffle, that was that. I don't know. That was your ex. That was just a weird. You had a fake twin flame. whoever the Sagittarius is, or whoever a Sagittarius is in their chart, this is your real twin. So if you thought you had a twin flame, you haven't met your twin flame yet. Okay? Well, you probably met this person, but you haven't been in this two cups of love because they're going through a breakup like since like last week or last month or maybe the other day. Okay, they're going through a breakup, a divorce. They don't want to be committed maybe to this Cancer or this water sign or this Scorpio because that individual is a karmic. Okay, now this person, someone blocked, I don't know how, what's this fool? Because look, you got the Lovers. Gemini and Sagittarius, it's like a brother-sister. So it could be either a Gemini or a Sagittarius because, yeah. Look it. To the Four of Wands, this is your real twin flame. Like, I've never, that's crazy. Oh my God. The Knight of Wands. On the upright, this person wants to be your hero. While you were dealing with that psychopath, this individual wants to be your hero or will be. This person wants to help you. This person wants to go in. This person could be either younger than you. To the Four of Wands. This, what? Get out of town. I never read these that, like, I don't like to get into the whole twin flame thing, okay? I'm not trying to get you all woo, but woo, listen. Oh my God, Collective. You have a soulmate, twin flame connection, someone that's highly attracted to you, very enthusiastic about you, very passionate about you. This person is your hero, will be your hero. And look, it's like this, they're all looking forward. They're looking at each other. But look at the man, he's looking forward. Look at the Eight of Wands, he's looking forward. And he's looking forward at you, to have a happy home with you. Is this individual breaking up with someone? Is this Sagittarius breaking up with someone? I got this in my reading. Look at my, like, four videos down. Is he already breaking up? Because there was a Sagittarius that wasn't available, but I think he is available now. Is this Sagittarius available now? Does someone try to block the Sagittarius from going towards the Collective? And whoever these people block, now they don't have no new beginnings? So you had a Scorpio and a Cancer that blocked, that try to block your soulmate, your twin flame coming through. And these people will not have a new beginning for that. Now, okay, now in the present, Vertigo energy, you're talking about loyalty right here. Someone is so confused right now. Someone is so delusional right now about what's going on. They're like, what the hell happened? Because they wanted to be in this psychopath energy. They wanted to be a psychopath trying to block your twin flame. This is like, you can't fuck with soulmate contracts and twin flame contracts. If these people don't understand why they're going through this world in reverse, a Leo, a Sagittarius, a Taurus, Aquarius, Vertigo. If they don't understand why they're not going through some type of karma, then they better get hip understanding that this Sagittarius or some person that has Sagittarius in their chart is supposed to go towards you from the get-go. And they block that opportunity from happening. And they're not understanding why they're not having no new beginnings. They don't understand why their world is chaos. They don't understand why they're going through breakups. They don't understand why they're not going to have any Ace of Cups. These are like people, these outside influences are very confused. What the hell is happening? And they don't get, they're not understanding that they're messing with a divine contract here. Because they're not believers, you know? This is high front in reverse. This is your emperor. This is your emperor. This person is getting out a very nasty divorce, breakup. This person is stable. This person is your emperor. A good father, very stable. Very stable. This person could have an AK. He wants to, yeah, he's divinely, yeah, to the Nine of Pentacles. This person is not, this person does not want to be committed to this water sign anymore. This individual does not want to be with whoever they're in a relationship with. This is very non, like, they don't want to commit to whatever, that's why they're getting a divorce or a breakup. Because they want to go and give to you. They want to go and give to you. This person is going to come in and this is going to be a very give and take relationship. This is going to be a, this person wants to give to you. They might be buying you gifts and stuff. The reason why this Nine of Pentacles in reverse is because whoever they're with or whoever they're breaking up with, they really don't want to be with that person anymore. It's like, I don't like you type of energy. Because this person is also a giver. They like give and take. I cannot make it up. Look. So they're breaking up with someone. They're breaking someone's heart right now. And what is this Knight of Wands? And so he's breaking up with someone. So this person's not, whoever these water signs are or whatever, who's ever with this emperor, they are not going to have a new beginning with this emperor. Because they block the opportunity to have it with you. And that's, and God's like, that's not how it works. You people cannot do, this is a contract in the ethers between you and this emperor. Only God can say anything about it. And this, these people are confused why they're like going through this now. But then you also got your karmic out here. Your psychopath past person that likes to have sex with underage girls. What the fuck, collective? What's this Knight of Wands? Pisces, again. This person is not gonna, this anti-hero energy does not want you to go on this new beginning. They don't want you to have a new beginning. They just don't. They really don't. They don't understand why you get a new beginning, and they don't. Because they don't tell the truth. They're not honest. They're lacking a piece of the puzzle. They don't have some type of clarity. This is a narcissist that lies. So then you wouldn't have a new beginning. This is a person that didn't want to protect you. This is an individual that is just bad. This person was really against you, collective. Like lying on you, really lying on you bad, so you wouldn't have a new beginning. This is so weird. And this person is reaping karma for it, like here soon. I'm telling you right now, they're gonna get in trouble with their phone. Something about their phone. Yeah, look. Well, you're gonna be able to be happy and live your life with the sun. Because this person didn't want to balance things out with you. They could have at least went in and apologized. This person's not going to, though. Well, you get a new beginning. This person cannot handle the fact that you're getting a new beginning. Regardless if you're with a soulmate or not. It's like they just can't handle it. But you overcame it. What are some challenges? Queen of Swords to the Three of Wands. They wanted you to shut the hell up. The challenges is you. You're speaking a truth. You've been speaking the truth. And this is why these people's plans are backfiring. And that's the challenge for them. Like, bad. Because the challenge is, or yeah, because they didn't want you to partner up. They didn't want you to work with someone. They didn't want you, this soulmate, to come in and team up with you. Or whoever they're working with, they could be facing challenges. Because there's a lot of secrets and illusion out here. About a breakup, about an Ace of Cups being dumped out. And now they're reaping karma for it. Again, the Chariot. To the Ten of Wands in reverse. I feel like this person didn't have a nervous breakdown. This person is going to... Ooh, this person is so delusional. Okay, so the challenge is that here you are speaking the truth, and this is why their plans are backfiring. And the challenge is that people are working with you. Someone's working with you. Someone's working with this Queen of Swords about these secrets. And someone with the Ten of Wands reverse is like, this person's going to be so fucking burdened that they're not going to be able to handle it. With the Chariot, it's like... I feel like they're going to have a nervous breakdown. Because it's like they're trying to achieve so much. And they're going to... There's so much... The Ace of Wands to the Fool to the Chariot in reverse. This person is not going to be able to move forward in anything. Until they release these secrets. Until they face the... Whatever illusion this is. But this Queen of Wands is working really hard. Collaborating with someone. Maybe you're going to be collaborating with the courts. I don't know. And this person's going to, like... It also tells me that the challenge is that the fact that you, like, you don't associate with this karmic, this whoever that those drug peoples are or whatever, that it just breaks them down. What's this, Chariot? Yeah, the Hermit in reverse. These people are not healed. These people they're not healed. They're not enlightening to the Five of Wands. They're fighting with each other. There's too much fighting going on. And the fact that you cut them out of your life with the Queen of Swords energy and the Ten of Wands is like you're not burdened by these people. You're not burdened by these people. And the plans backfired about these secrets, and you're teaming up with someone. And that's bothering them? What's this moon? The Devil. I told you, you release this person. You're not bound to this illusion. Capricorn energy. Cancer. Scorpio. There's definitely water signs out here. Pisces, Scorpio, and a Cancer for sure. With the Ten of Wands and the Devil is you cut a karmic out. And this person is not going to be able to move forward. This person is going to go through a major freaking, like, breakdown or a mental break in the future. Because everybody knows that they were being stingy or not letting go of your energy so you could get into this Four of Wands. So you could be with your twin flame. Wow, that's crazy. What's this Queen of Swords? Hey, yeah, you're speaking the truth. So that's why everything is going returned back to them. Because a Queen of Swords in reverse now. Hey, this could be this Libra. This Queen of Swords in reverse is liar, this manipulator, this person that lacks the intelligence, okay? All that energy is going back to with them because teamwork. The challenge is that these people are working together to cause illusions, but you're not even burdened by this. Whoever this Queen of Swords is like, they threw so many obstacles out of their, like, out there with this. This is like people at work, people they work with, people they talk to, people they communicate, because they're trying to cause illusions. They're trying to make people not see something about you, but you release this energy. You're not bound to this energy. You cut these people out. You're not even burdened by these people, because look, it's with the Hangman in reverse, it's just returning back to them over and over and over. This is why they're stuck in their own illusions. With the Seven of Cups and the Moon, yeah, these people are like delusional. There's like another word I'm trying to find. It's like they're stuck in their own, the challenge is like they're stuck in their own thoughts of delusions. Like they are, and they're working with people to do this. It's so crazy. What's going to be the final outcome? So not only you're this truth speaker, you're a sweetheart. You're a good mother. You're nurturing. You're caring. You're loving. Okay? And you have someone that resents you for that. You have somebody that really resents you, that you're this, that you're honest, that you have integrity, that you're sweet and you're kind, and this person hates you for it. They really blocked any opportunity for you in the past. Because here you are in the upright. You're a Gemini. I could be talking to a Gemini with the Queen of Swords. You're very smart, you're very intelligent, and people resent you for that. And whoever was this person didn't want you to have a new beginning, Gemini. Lovers up here with a Sagittarius. Brothers, sisters, right there. A Gemini and Sagittarius are definitely supposed to be together. Okay? This is a twin flame connection, and you're supposed to have a happy home with this person. Okay? You're supposed to be like this person's like baby mama. And you're speaking the truth about it now, about why these people, like, you know, I think as well, why these people are blocking. Does a Sagittarius know? Yeah. What's going to be the next step for this Gemini and Sagittarius? Yeah, challenges, making decisions, working on inner healing. These people threw so many challenges for this twin flame connection to happen. Electric issues, communication, issue reviewing everything. Someone got their eye on you. They're doing your research. So after the Mercury retrograde, this person is now this Sagittarius could be watching you. But they're going through a lot of challenges with this divorce. What's the next step? There's a dark feminine energy out here that wasn't loyal, that was very impulsive, and now they're stuck in this Five of Pentacles energy. They're sick. That could be your karmic as well, even though it's a female, because remember, it's like you were the past person that goes in between men and women. I hate to tell you that, but that's that. That's just that, okay? This individual is sick. This person was very impulsive. They think they're right. Their ego, very egotistical, okay? Because Yeah, they're going through a lot of challenges because they're stuck. They threw so many obstacles in this twin flame connection that they're stuck. They sabotage themselves. They really sacrifice themselves trying to sacrifice you. They could even been trying to do some black magic on you. They're really, this person is very ego, like egotistical, very narcissistic, this energy. This person is very sick in the head because they're attached to this Queen of Swords in reverse. Again, this is an individual that's not smart. Manipulative, lies a lot, and your past karmic person, your fake twin flame was working with this person, but their plans are backfired. Also with a Scorpio that's like low vibrational, this is why they're gonna have no new opportunities. Also with a Cancer that's low vibrational, that are going through breakups, heartaches, something's heartbreaking for these people. Something's breaking these people's hearts. Oh, that you get a gift. Sorry, my bad. That it breaks their heart that you're getting a gift from an emperor. Like, this is so fucking weird. Okay? That's what's breaking their heart, is that this emperor doesn't want to commit to whatever relationship that they're in. This is why they're going through a divorce. And it breaks their heart that this emperor wants to give you a gift, or this emperor is your gift. Again, this is your real twin flames. They can't stop this happening. Okay? Even if this Sagittarius didn't even think of you as their twin flame, it's just that's the way it is. And these people, they don't understand. They don't believe in this stuff or whatever, but let them. Like, that's their problem, you know? What's this emperor? What's going to happen for this emperor that's breaking up with someone? What's going to happen for this emperor? Yeah, this emperor's breaking up with a gold digger that was just using them for their money. This gold digger put a love spell on this emperor. What? Someone wants to confess this to you. So you might, when you get in with your twin flame, they're going to tell you that they were the gold digger and that they knew that they were put on, that bitch put a spell on them. This high priestess in reverse, whoever this dark feminine energy is, this person did black magic on your twin flame. On your real twin flame. Probably not even realizing that that was your twin flame, and that's the reason why. It's like maybe they could have been doing tarot cards and like, oh, wait a minute. I need this money because they're a gold digger, right? They're supposed to be with the collective. Oh, no. They might even went to your karmic, your fake twin, and started shit with them. Yeah, this is crazy. And these people are working together. I told you, you're... fake twin flame is literally working with this individual's fake twin flame. What? Three of Pentacles. What's the next step for this? Who, anyways? But you're going to get your Nine of Pentacles. You're going to get an upgrade. Because someone is very challenged by this, too. They're very challenged that you're going to be, maybe you're going to be working with someone. And this person is going to set you in a very luxury life, okay? Because someone wants to be loyal to you with the Vertigo energy, or I'm talking to a Vertigo, okay? And these people are so confused what is going on. These people don't even understand, like, the divine, like, they don't understand. They don't understand. Not that the fact they don't understand how you're getting this upgrade by working with someone, they just don't understand what's going on in their life. Okay? Like, they don't understand why they're going through the karma that they're going through. And whoever this psychopath is, okay, this person didn't use protection. And now this person is, like, very confused, very, like, mentally confused. And this person is not going to have a new beginning at life. This person is going to go through, they have maybe, why am I getting, does syphilis make you do that? Doesn't syphilis make you go crazy? Because this person wasn't using protection? That's not for all of you. Doesn't syphilis make you go crazy? So I'm telling you, someone's going to the loony bin. Because they weren't, yeah, something like that. Anyways, I'm not going to tap into that dude's energy anymore. That's just weird. Your karmic and their karmic was really working really hard together. But here you are, single, independent, free, living a luxury life right now as we speak. Next step for an audition. You graduated school, you're a master, whatever you're working at, you got a promotion at your job. And again, your ex-lover can't stand it. Your karmic, your fake twin cannot stand that you are a master at whatever you're doing. They cannot stand it, collective. They can't, they hate it. Because the challenge is that they're, now this person is so delusional. This person is going, the challenge is that you release this individual. Whatever these secrets are, whatever this illusion is, you don't care anymore. And this is what the challenge is. Because if you're bound to these secrets, this person with the Four of Pentacles, this person can still hold you to something. Does that make sense? But they can't anymore because you mastered something. You moved on from this ex-lover of yours. And now this person is not going to have they can't grow from the situation. They can't expand. Because they know they can't have this Ace of Cups with you anymore. Or with anyone. Well, you have a new beginning. This person is like cuckoo. Because look, you have the sun. You're going to be happy in a new beginning with a child. Or you're just happy. With a lot of order. This is like divine order here. Like God is placing everything in order for you while these people's worlds are upside down, literally. Upside down. Not even getting the understanding why they're going through this karma. Like, totally delusional. I just have to clarify one thing though. What's this, why is this Two of Pentacles keeps coming out? In reverse. Why is this Two of Pentacles coming out in reverse? Justice. Told you. So the justice system is going to set this motherfucker off balance. This person is, justice is coming in. Divine justice, court, whatever. This person is getting in trouble. Page of Swords. The justice system is going to defend you, defend something. And someone's walking away to offer you a cup of love, a message of love, while someone is literally Six of Swords. Someone does not want you to walk away. I don't know. It's so weird. It's like this person doesn't want to be with you, but they don't want you to walk away. They don't want you to walk away from, because I feel like they want to get you caught up in the justice system or something like that. It's like they don't want you to, they want you to be bound to a situation, but you're not, because you overcame everything right here. It's like, I don't know why they're hanging on to your energy. It's, I'm not even getting the feeling that they don't want to be with you because they don't want to offer you that Ace of Cups. Every time they'll be with you, they'll just dump it right out. I don't know what they're hanging on to. It's like, maybe that gift is with you and they want that gift. What's the next step around this situation right here? This is a past person that does not like you. Past people. Your past haters. Your past lover. Okay? That the obstacles is that they're fighting to heal. They're fighting to heal. And this person literally is going through a nervous breakdown because you cut them out of your life. Because they're doing some bad things with technology. And everybody knows that they're being stingy about this twin flame connection, about a home, about you being in a marriage, like hanging on to you energetically. Or they could be literally hanging on to a home or being stingy about a home. But the something that was unfair for you. What's this Four of Pentacles? Oh, right there. Look, this person's going to jail. No new money opportunity. Because they were with a gold digger. There's a gold digger that does black magic, for sure. With the Hierophant reverse and the Magician reverse, yeah, your twin flame is going... What's going to happen with this twin flame situation? What's going to happen with this twin flame situation? It's protected. And these people are defeated. And again, you guys are going to overcome a lot of obstacles together, but you guys are going to be together. I feel like this twin flame is protected. This contract is protected because these people are reaping karma. Because it's not completed. This is an incomplete cycle with your twin flame. So that's why God is like putting it on hold. Waiting. I saw the cups of love. And a betrayal is going to be revealed. You're going to heal from all this. You and your past person. Or you and your twin flame. Sorry, my bad. And you're going to be single. Why is the collective single? Because someone's talking shit. Someone is like really talking shit. Gossiping. About you being happy. About you getting a 10 of cups. They cannot walk away from talking shit about you. Obsessing. Stalking you. Be lying, 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 lying. Manipulate them like someone is just doing a lot of injustice in your life. Again, what's going to happen with this twin flame connection? Or is the collective going to be with them? Okay, someone's not working really hard. I don't know, collective. I don't think... Judgment. Ooh. Your twin flame is also under judgment. It's like this feeling of like, they got your twin flame caught up. Is the collective gonna end up being with their twin flame? Is the collective gonna end up being in with their twin flame? Yeah. After this judgment, huh? Is the collective's twin flame under judgment? No, see, these people are going to be gossip. Oh, these people are not learning. This judgment's heavy. Are these people going to jail for some reason? For stalking? For other reasons? With the justice system in reverse. These people were trying to falsely accuse you. There's your queen. There's your King Wands right there. Who's unhappy, but they're feeling very innovative about you, so they're gonna end it, because this karmic is not their wish desire, you are, so they don't want to miss this opportunity with you to have these 10 of cups, and that's when this person is very, this emperor energy, he's very fair. These people are delusional. How you're going to be this Queen of Wands. These people are delusional about how... You might be a tarot reader. Or you might be connected to the divine too. With the Queen of Cups. Or Queen of Wands. The justice system, law. Anyways, yeah, these people are still... They don't understand what's going on. Just say that. They resent you. They hate you, collective, because you're winning. You got the lovers and the soulmate. You got the lovers, the four of wands, the two of cups. You have a soulmate out there that's coming through. Is he or she gonna be here within the year for the collective? Is this twin flame gonna come in within the year? Within 5 months? Is this twin coming in within 5 months? Okay, after 5 months? Yeah, that's what I feel. It's like this feeling of like all this other shit needs to be settled out, collective. So just give it time. Just be patient. I know you probably don't want to hear that. You just got to be patient with this, your real twin flame coming, because these people put a lot of obstacles in the way to make sure you didn't have a twin flame connection. They could have been doing tarot card readings. They possibly don't even know who this individual is. They were just doing a lot of black magic, whatever it is, and now they're reaping what they sow. These people could be going to jail for different things. They could be getting caught up for different things. It doesn't matter. These people have to go through this judgment because they were trying to do a lot of unfairness in your life. So give it time. All right? Okay. Please share, like, and subscribe to my channel. All right. Bye. Good night, everyone. Love you guys.